Welcome, everybody. This is Dave, Classic Gamers HQ. Thank you for joining me today. We are playing Goragoa. It is a indie game available on Steam right now, just released. Just found out about it this morning from a awesome Let's Player, John Wolf. Props to him. I've been watching a lot of his videos over the past couple of years, and he has introduced many, many indie games that are unexpectedly pretty awesome. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started. Goragoa. And it's a puzzle adventure, so let's see what's happening. Let's see what's going on here. Dragon of some sort. Yep. Yes, because that's what I do. When a big monster walks by my window, I look in my Encyclopedia Britannica and see what the hell it is. Okay. What is this? Okay, full screen, language, music's up, chapter select. Okay, I got a bowl with five poofs of smoke, something. Green, blue, red, yellow, and purple. Okay, so I've got different tiles here. Move this one over, it breaks it apart. Interesting. There's a bowl. He obviously wants to fill it with the five poofs of smoke or whatever it is. Looks like I can overlap the doors, maybe? This way or this way? Uh-oh. So now he's in a different place. Disabled man. Who's bird watching? Okay. With the red one. Oh, I'm like creating one picture here. Mm-hmm.
go.
Okay, I've got a red apple. Achievement unlocked. Fruit for, or first fruit. Interesting. It's not poofs of smoke, it's fruit. Is he wanting to collect fruit to feed the dragon? Okay, the man is thinking about the kid walking up the steps. Green symbols here. Alright, so I carried him over to the next tile. I've got three tiles to work with now. He's waiting in position for the green fruit. Go this way, dude. Using this tile just yet. There you go. Okay. I forget I have a fourth tile here. So let's see. I move this over here. This here. Would you look at that? Separated tile to added tile. Okay, that works. Alright, so this is the illustration here. We've done this. Now I need to go get my fruit. Go in here. Eyes. Find it. Well, that's kind of crazy. No. That was pretty cool. There's my green apple. Second fruit. I need a yellow fruit. That's kind of pretty. I like that. Okay, that's this next one, looking up to the star to get the fruit. Interesting. I wish I could read what he's reading. it, huh? Flag of some sort? Some colors? She's putting a star and a lantern. There's a lantern. Ain't that some shit? That star again. No. Oh! Of course. I forgot I could put the tiles together. How? But how? Okay, let's go back over here and blam. We lit up the lantern. Nice. That's a pretty intricate, detailed-looking moth there. Pretty cool. Okay, he's reading up some materials about the moth. Back to the boy. It's like the never-ending story, except a whole lot crazier. Looks like it goes together. Yep. Broken horse. Yet another boy reading up on mythological whatevers. What's up with that? What's the significance of that? There's a crack right there. He's reading about meteors raining down on buildings. I've got essentially what could be a meteor coming down. Am I wanting to let the moth out? He's reading about star clusters. Something. Star, the moon, the star clusters. Okay. Of course, the moth is trying to get to the light. Missing something here. Let's back up. Let's go this way. That looks like... Ah! There we go. Whoa, hey. Oh, okay, I put those together. Out. Back over here and see what I can figure out. Oh. So I've got to catch it there. I gotta make this happen again. Now what? Shit. Oh, I see. I see. Gotta do some quick little switcheroo things right here, so... There we go. Come on, catch it for me, baby. Zoom back in here and bam. Go. A moth can go to the light and kill himself. Interesting. Oh, we're doing this again, huh? Away we go on our journey to wherever the next piece of fruit. Yet another boy studying up on his mythology. Interesting. They're all studying up on dragons and star clusters and time. Here's a like a pressure gauge. Ooh. Oh, he's sleepy. Looks like the moon. It is the moon. Okay, so where do I need to go? There's a clock. No. Okay, 5 o'clock. Oh. No, it's a full-fledged clock instead of a pressure gauge. Interesting. Whatever that is set to, like, what is that, 719 or 722? Oh. So over here. Which one does that point toward? Not the moon. That's the compass, that's the pressure gauge. How do I make adjustments to the pressure gauge? Holy crap. Oh. Well, how do I keep it there? Nice. That's the time set to be able to look at the star at its best, I guess. Hmm. Now what? There we go. Now it's lit up. Okay. Now I'm going to zoom in on his little wing. Separate that. Creepy. There we go. Beautiful. And there's our yellow fruit. Awesome. Third fruit, achievement unlocked. We got what, 5 fruits total? Okay. Blue fruit. He's dreaming about falling. Interesting. Let's see, what's next? Does that look kind of familiar? Kind of? Maybe? Ooh. It's a map of sorts. I don't know what it's doing for me here. Let's go up some stairs. This is thoroughly confusing. She's handing her a sphere of some sort. Doesn't make a whole lot of sense. We gotta complete his bridge. I think. I see. I need to start looking for similarities of things. I need it to go back to the 9 o'clock position. This one? The one that's on the right now. So he can complete his bridge and he can move on to the right. So these don't have to be vertical or horizontal, they just need to match. Okay, those walls look like they match. Boom. I don't think the steps have anything to do with anything just yet. Isn't that interesting? Flower looks a lot like this, kind of. Okay, what matches here? Alright, so... the boy is... Alright, here's the temple, the opening... I think that's it right there. To be in the 12 o'clock position. There we go. Success. Okay, so I need stairs now. Thing. The dude climbing the steps and Oh, holy hell. This building looks upside down even. This is what's throwing me off right here. There's an Eve on the building. But look, he needs to go from here to here?